Hello and welcome. Once again, I'm bringing a roundup of the biggest news from the past few days. Today, we have some major updates: RPCS 3 for Android with an official port, a new Game Boy Advance emulator focused on accuracy, improvements to the Xbox One emulator, a PlayStation 4 emulator for Android, and new native ports of Xbox 360 games for Windows. Additionally, you can now test Azahor, an emulator developed by two giants of the scene. We'll also talk about the return of the Yuzu and Yuzu mod for Android, now with support for new games, along with several updates on Nintendo Switch emulators. But first, a message from our sponsors: a huge discount on Monster Hunter Wilds. If you want to buy original games while saving a lot, check out Instant Gaming, the digital store that sells games for various platforms, such as PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Nintendo Switch. Get games of all genres with discounts of up to 95%. You'll also find a variety of gift cards and credits for other services. You can pay for your order through your credit card on a website with a 4.7 rating on Trustpilot. You're buying games directly from Instant Gaming, not from other retailers. If you encounter any issues, Instant Gaming offers 24/7 support. And this month, Instant Gaming is offering a great discount on the newly released Monster Hunter Wilds, with up to 51% off, ensuring the lowest historical price for the game. Check out the price comparison with Steam's pricing. What are you waiting for to save? Links in the description. Before we get started, I want to know your opinion. Since many people like this video format, I'm thinking of making it bi-weekly instead of monthly. If you'd like to see this type of content more often, leave a comment. And of course, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Additionally, all the links to the mentioned projects will be available on a free page on Patreon, where everything will be organized for easy access. Quick notice: the images used to illustrate the projects are for illustration purposes only and may not necessarily have been captured with the mentioned emulators. If you've been following the controversy around APS 3e and its abusive monetization, you already know it wasn't the best solution for emulating PS3 on Android. But now, we have an official port of RPCS 3, developed by DHRPCS 3, one of the people responsible for the original project. Those who were expecting much better performance than APS 3e might be disappointed, as running 3D games at an acceptable level still requires at least a Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, and the most recommended would be a Snapdragon Elite. The big question is, with optimization, could this emulator become a viable alternative, or will it only be worth it for those with the most powerful phones on the market? Moving on to a suggestion from Boss, we have a new Game Boy Advance emulator called Nano Boy Advance. Unlike other available options, it focuses on accuracy, and in my tests, it showed results very faithful to the original hardware. Although it's a lesser-known project, it manages to emulate the handheld impressively. Among its main features are high compatibility, support for HQ Audio Mixer for compatible games, post-processing options for image customization with color correction, XBRZ upscaling, and simulation of the LCD ghosting effect, which is quite noticeable. It also supports up to 10 save state slots, compatibility with various types of controllers, loading of ROMs compressed in formats like ZIP, 7Z, TAR, and RAR, RDC emulation for games that use the GBA's internal clock, solar sensor emulation, and debugging tools. The gameplay shown in the background was captured directly from the emulator, and overall, the experience was positive. The only downside was the graphical quality in Mario Kart, but that might have been an error on my part during setup. If you like accuracy, I'll leave the project's Discord and update links on the download page. Now, let's talk about Swine, the compatibility layer that will soon allow emulating Xbox One games on Windows. It's already been shown to run Minecraft on WinLater. But of course, the community is more interested in titles like Forza Horizon 2. While it's possible to play it on Xenia, the Xbox 360 version is the worst of all, as it suffered several cuts to promote the newer hardware. During initial tests, some objects show excessive shadows, but as the gameplay progresses, even the car shadows start behaving more faithfully to the original console. There's still some polishing to do, but I hope to get access to a test build soon. And we hardly have a functional PlayStation 3 emulator on Android, and already there's a project for PlayStation 4. Shandrid PS4 doesn't have much concrete information yet, and its GitHub is currently just a clone of Shad PS4. After digging deeper, I found a Reddit post that seems to have been written by the developer himself, where he mentions working on a recompiler that translates x64 instructions to ARM64. The biggest challenge is porting this to Android, and he's even considering leveraging some solutions from WinLater. Some people suggest he use RPCS 3's ARM libraries, while others are making memes asking for Bloodborne to run on extremely weak phones like the Samsung Galaxy J. but it looks like he's taking the idea seriously and is already working on a project called Lightfast PS4, which does real-time conversion of ARM64 instructions from Android to PS4 x86-64. Now, we'll have to wait and see if this project will be functional on recent devices or if it's something we'll only see in the future. And if you followed the scene last week, you saw all the media talking about the version of Sonic Unleashed that was never officially ported by Sega, but now has been decompiled from the Xbox 360 version and is available for PC, with a possibility of coming to other platforms in the future if someone is interested in porting the game. This opens the door for the decompilation of many other games, but as I mentioned in my last video on the subject, it's not enough to simply convert the code and run a different game to get the decompilation. Some adjustments are needed. However, things are moving faster than expected, and there's already a new project called Xenon Decomp, which is essentially a master decompiler, created to help developers by providing methods and documentation to accelerate the process. To our surprise, there's already another game in the decompilation process, Midnight Club Los Angeles, a title that has never been officially released for PC by Rockstar. However, unlike Sega, who has yet to take any action against the Sonic project, Rockstar already has a history of disputes with the community, especially when it comes to fan-made ports. There was a case involving GTA mods, where Rockstar initially blocked the projects, which caused outrage and led the developers to release the mod without requiring the original game. If all goes well, in a few weeks or months, we might finally have Midnight Club Los Angeles available for PC. Now, it's also possible to obtain Azahor builds. Although they aren't listed in the official releases yet, you can download them directly from the artifacts generated in the test builds. For those who don't remember, Azahor is the fusion of the two best Citra forks, Lime 3DS and the Pablunk 7 fork, one of the people responsible for several improvements to the original project. To run games on this emulator, the files need to be in CCI format, but since the 3DS format was already decrypted, just convert the games to CCI, and they will run normally. Over the past year of development for these projects, considerable improvements have been made, such as enhanced performance in Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon. However, what stands out the most in Azahor is its complete departure from illegally obtained media. At the moment, there aren't any significant performance gains to highlight, but it wouldn't be surprising if, at some point, this becomes the best emulator for playing Nintendo 3DS. Now, let's talk about Nintendo Switch emulators, which make up most of our video, starting with Strato, but not the conventional version, and instead, a fork created by Sudachi developer Jared. To put things into context, after Jared announced that he would stop updating Sudachi due to the Android community's toxicity, he revealed that he would be helping in the development of the original Strato. This project hadn't seen updates since February 2024 according to the official site, although the PRs on GitHub show activity up until December 2024 and some new updates in February 2025. This suggests that the original Strato might be slowly making a comeback. However, speaking specifically about Jared's fork, some changes were made 2 weeks ago, but since then, there have been no public updates. Additionally, he has committed to porting RPCS3 to Android after the APS3E monetization controversy. The big question is, can one developer manage Sudachi, Folium, Strato, and also an RPCS3 fork for Android? Personally, I think it's difficult, considering Sudachi's recent update pace. But what do you think? Do you think we'll finally see a Skyline port now? Another innovative project that seeks to distance itself from piracy is NXEMU. This would be a new Nintendo Switch emulator that doesn't require the necessary keys to load commercial games, unlike the Yuzu and Ryujinx forks. In the past, there was a project called Nozomi, which had a similar proposal, but it's unclear if there's a direct connection between it and NXEMU. For those who understood the Azahor concept, the logic is similar. While Azahor requires games to be in decrypted format, eliminating the need for illegal methods, NXEMU aims to follow the same path, but adapted for the Switch. However, unlike Nozomi, which was a completely new project, NXEMU will be a fork of Yuzu. The developer assures that it won't just be a port, as they want to understand each component of the console and integrate them into the code they will develop. Unlike a port, where the components are inherited, in this case, most of the code will need to be rewritten to avoid compatibility issues. Currently, Nozomi can run the Switch calculator in its version 0.1, and the developer states it will still take quite some time for this emulator to reach Yuzu's level. And if you think that the new Yuzu or Ryujinx forks just worsen performance and make the interface more cluttered, or if you miss Yuzu before its shutdown, we now have a new interesting project. For those who remember Yuzu, a Yuzu fork for Android that had spectacular performance. Our Discord user, Pavel Barabanov, is making changes to both Yuzui and Yuzu to implement compatibility with games that previously didn't work, like Princess Peach, Showtime, and Donkey Kong Returns HD. I haven't talked much with him about the project, but I often see his code modifications, so even though it's something he does in his spare time, it looks like serious work. The gameplays he sent show stable performance, and one thing I noticed is that he seems to have even implemented Yuzui's generator in the latest updates. For anyone who wants to follow the project, Pavel is using a section of my Discord, and the link will be available to you. If he decides to create his own server, I'll update the link. With the constant emergence of new emulators, it seemed like Nintendo had given a break, but that's not quite the case. First, let me talk about my own experience. I had a Ryujinx fork I created 3 years ago, but it was just a clone since I'm a beginner in the subject and didn't modify anything. Even so, I received a DMCA notice, which was reviewed by Zephyron, the developer of Citrin, and confirmed as legitimate. Since there was nothing to lose, I just deleted the repository. Shortly after, Ryujinx Mirror also received a DMCA, which was verified in the same way. Just like in my case, they had 24 hours to adjust the code, but they didn't make any changes, and the repository was taken down. However, unlike my case, they decided to contest the removal, and for that, they will need legal counsel. At the moment, the Ryujinx Mirror GitHub is offline, but the project has been hosted on another Git. Anyone who wants to follow can check the project's Discord, but in the end, I believe that if Nintendo wants, it can issue another DMCA. The only way to fully protect against this would be to host your own Git, as Citrin and Sadachi do. Now, talking about the pre-0.6 version of Citrin, like the other projects I mentioned earlier, Citrin is also working to completely disconnect from piracy. As part of this initiative, they are working to remove the need for keys files, completely eliminating this dependency. I've been following this development for at least 2 weeks, but as of this script's editing, this change has not been finalized yet. Another new feature is the implementation of PGO, Profile Guided Optimization. Without getting too technical, PGO essentially generates shaders twice. First, a special version for Citrin, then, the emulator creates an execution profile based on this data, allowing it to learn which codes are executed more frequently. This can bring benefits such as performance improvement between 5% and 20%, depending on the game, more efficient use of the CPU instruction cache, better prediction of branches and critical emulation loops, optimizations focused on the most played games on Citrin. If there are no regressions, this feature should be available in the next version, as there's already a build for beta testers. But if you want the cherry on top, here it is. As I mentioned earlier, Citrin was developing an online multiplayer mode for Android. Now, the tests have been successfully completed, and the developer confirmed to me that Citrin is a pioneer in this. With this new feature, it will be possible to play cross-play between Citrin on Android and users on Windows and Linux. Additionally, other emulators like Yuzu, Sadachi, Suyu, and Torza will also be compatible with this mode. This makes Citrin the first Switch emulator to offer support for online multiplayer on Android, marking a major breakthrough for mobile emulation. On the other hand, an emulator that's leaving us is Suyu. The project admins released a statement announcing its closure. According to the team, the project will be in an almost archived state. The email server will be shut down by the end of the month, with no new signups for Git or chat. SSH access to Git will be terminated by the end of the month. Git can still be accessed via Tor. The website and Git repository will remain available for now. The domain is scheduled to expire in early 2026. The reason for the Suyu shutdown, according to the developers themselves, is that the project has not received contributions in recent months, the leadership lost interest, the web service has been broken for a long time, and no one is willing to rewrite it. Additionally, they recommend that users migrate to Citrin as an alternative to Yuzu unless someone steps in to rewrite the web service and take on the infrastructure costs to keep Suyu alive. Now, a news piece that almost went unnoticed. A new version of Simu for Android has finally been released, version 0.1 of S5, and for the first time, I felt there were significant improvements. The performance in Zelda, Breath of the Wild showed a noticeable boost. I won't say the experience is perfect unless you have a high-end phone, but it's already a huge leap. In previous versions, I was getting around 7 FPS in the game, and now the performance is much better. Another game I tested was Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Before, the game was extremely slow and didn't take advantage of the device's hardware. Now, while it's still not 100%, I consider the game playable. all the graphical issues have been resolved, with only excessive blur in some stages remaining. Lastly, Mario Kart 8 also received a well-optimized version, with good speed and corrections on excessive shadows. Depending on your device, this could be the best version to play Mario Kart 8 on Android. I'll be testing more games soon, so if you like SiMiu, stay tuned. And that's the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.